falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
So, Theresa, there's all sorts of jargon surrounding racing, like there is, I guess, with most industries, but a lot of that comes around track work, and you've got these three basic types of work: slow work, pace work, and fast work. So let's just look at those one by one. Well, what is slow work exactly?
So slow work we refer to is just basically trot and canter work. So typically, when they first come in, they're basically doing slow work just to build up their fitness levels before you start stepping them up to some pace work. So we do most of our slow work on the poly track. So they'll either do one or two laps, and that'll consist of, they'll sort of trot over, trot off, and then canter around. As depending on the horse, we usually like to bowl ours around at the canter. And it just depends on the horse as to exactly how fast they go and what sort of work they do, but typically they just canter around, and just a nice strong bowling canter, and they typically do that for about 3 weeks when they first come into work.
Right.
And then once they get up doing a bit of pace work, typically every second morning, sort of a slow work day, and the alternate days are your fast work or pace work days.
Right. And so then to look at the next grade up, that's pace work. So what's that exactly?
So that's where you just start to bowl them along a little bit quicker. So as you progress through a preparation, it's incremental. So you're building their fitness. So they'll sort of start off doing their slow work, and then you'll start to do a bit of three-quarter work. So as a rough guide, three-quarter work's basically 15 seconds to the furlong, or 15 seconds per 200 metres.
Yep.
Now, your three-quarter work can be slightly different depending on your horse. Some horses that are quite long and scopy and got a big stride about them, their three-quarter pace might be a little bit closer to 14 seconds.
Right.
And then you get other horses that their three-quarter pace might be 16 seconds. So there's no hard and fast rule. And I'm very lucky to have some very experienced track work riders.
Yeah.
So our philosophy is it's not about going out there and going exactly 15 seconds to the furlong. It depends on the horse and how they feel. And sometimes a horse is better going that half a second quicker and doing the work easier in themselves, rather than trying to hold them back to 15 seconds of furlong and having them pulling really hard. It's just that it's that foundation work and getting them fit, so they start to do. They'll start off going 600 or 800 metres three-quarter, and then sort of build up to 1,000 metres three-quarter. And then again, it depends on whether you've got a sprinter or a stayer as to how far you stretch that out over.
Yeah. And so with slow work, you're basically building up their strength, their muscular strength and skeletal strength. And then when you move into pace work, you're starting to get a bit of aerobic work in as well. Is that the idea?
Yes, that's exactly right. Yeah. And you don't want to be stepping into your fast work too quickly. Like the way these horses are built, and with all their tendons and muscles and that, you want to be conditioning your tendons and muscles so that they can cope with the work as you step up.
Right. And so then, talking of fast work, so how do you define that?
So that's where they start to sprint up a little bit quicker.
Yeah.
Now, different trainers do different things with fast work. We're probably not ones that hammer ours with a lot of really fast flat out gallops. I'm not big into timing them and seeing how quick they can run on the track. So it's about improving in their work over those final stages. So the way we look at it is you want to teach your horses to find the line and where the finishing post is. So you always want them doing their best work on the line. So as you start to get through the three-quarter pace stage and they're getting fitter, then you start to let them sprint up the last furlong to start with, and then the last 400 metres. We don't gallop ours a lot, flat out a lot further than the 400 metres.
Yeah,
and we're lucky
right.
here with the nice big tracks at Kembla.
Yes.
With the nice long straights that you can sort of come around the home turn and let them balance up and then go through their gears. So you're not putting undue pressure on them around tight turns.
Yeah.
And yeah, each horse is a little bit different into exactly what fast work you do with them and how hard you work them.
Yeah.
Again, depends on what sort of distance they're going over. It depends on your horse and how they cope with the work. If you've got a light framed little filly that doesn't carry a lot of condition, then you probably don't work them as hard as a big gross gelding that sort of doesn't overexert themselves in their work.
Yeah.
That's where you get the finer points of training, and yeah, it's all about knowing your horse and
yeah.
And a lot of it, sometimes it's trial and error too, and trying different things with horses to get the best out of them.
Yeah. And then another thing you often hear as a client, you talk to trainers, and there's this idea of 4-1, 5-2. What's that all about?
So that's essentially just describing your work. So it's probably going back to the old school of where we talked furlongs and that.
Yeah.
So 4-2 is essentially 800 metres, 3/4 pace, and then they're sprinting up the last 400 metres.